How are you today? Do you remember last week Nikki took us to the midnight library? Yeah, you remember? Very good. And then so many of you asked Nikki to take them to many different places. Yeah? Yes. So today Nikki is going to take us to a new place. Do you want to go?
The story that I'm going to tell you today is called Opposite Fun. It was written by Kiran Kasturbia, illustrated by Neeta Gangopadhyay, and it is published by Children's Book Trust. So, let's get started.
Chinku and Minku, two naughty brothers, always do things opposite to each other. If Chinku puts all the toys inside the box, Minku loves putting them outside the box. If Chinku sits on a chair, his plate of food over the table. Minku sits on the floor, his plate under the table. One day, Chinku and Minku visit the zoo with their mother. They see a policeman where four roads meet together.
"Mommy, look!" yells Chinku. "The policeman there sometimes says stop, sometimes says go there. On the road, having fun, doing things opposite. The policeman too is enjoying every bit of it."
At the zoo, they see an elephant standing. And nibbling a banana close by is a mouse sitting.
"Mommy," Minku says, "look how big that elephant is."
And Chinku states,
"see, so small this mouse is."
Happy watching the animals roaming free, they now see a giraffe munching leaves from a tree. The giraffe's neck, they observe, is long and thin. But the rhino's neck is short and thick, hidden as it is among the folds of its skin. "Come on, children, it is time to go home. The rest we shall see when we come again and roam." As they come out, Minku says he wants jalebis, crisp and hot, while Chinku demands rasagollas, cold and soft. Munching jalebis and rasagollas happily, Chinku and Minku thank Mummy heartily.
"Opposites can be fun," both of them say. "We learned it on our trip to the zoo today."